The press asked me, they said, what is it like working with Dali? And I said, I have no idea. I said, because I don't understand a word he's saying and I don't know what he's doing. And Dali jumped up and he says, perfect. He says, confusion is the greatest form of communication.
People have asked me about this Nikon D lighting setting, and yes, you can get images closer to film by adjusting this setting in your camera. Normally I use flash, but in this case I didn't. So the shadows are really dark in the standard profile. It's a very contrasty profile. And they're gonna be printed black. And the colors are kinda dead. So de-lighting, and that's in your camera, right? In your camera. But you can preview the results in Nikon software. This is low. This is normal, and this is high. Some people are gonna say, I'm gonna put it at high because the 5x7s are gonna be really nice. True. My only problem with the high setting is that the color starts getting a little bit on the fake side, on what we would call digital color. I would say that you're gonna get fine prints at normal, but personally, I have it on low, and then I'm gonna go into the standard profile in the camera and reduce contrast by 1 point. And if I wanna see a preview of what it's going to look like, this is the picture control utility by which you can create your own presets. With -1 point contrast, it's going to bring up the shadows a little bit and smoothen out the face. Of course, in this software, you can do all sorts of stuff over here. This is a Nikon software, it's for free. And save it to file, save it on your camera, and have it as a different name in your camera for whatever special shooting you wanna do. You can even play with curves over here. Oh, look, Kodachrome. Of course, de-lighting and all the shooting profiles and presets that you have in your camera do not affect the RAW file itself. but they do slightly affect the camera's exposure because all digital cameras, all of them, they create their exposure histograms on the basis of the JPEG data, not the RAW data. And finally, the only way to reverse delighting is to use Nikon software. Other software does not have a delighting control. Nikon software does. That's why I keep mine at low or I turn it off. Of course, the color in your images is a result of the shooting profile and the white balance and all that, but there was one lens that kind of broke the rules. And of course, bloggers and testers were pointing that out about the color saturation. Back in 2017, this was my very first image with a Nikon D850, and I happened to have this lens on, and I noticed the red color immediately. Now, these two images, do you see the red changing? These are RAW files. The red on the tree doesn't change much, right? Look at the table and chair on the bottom of the image. The reddish table and chair doesn't change much, right? Then I also noticed very anaglyph structures. Very descriptive, very nice. Supreme micro contrast. When the sun got out at aperture 3.5, I had pretty much everything in focus at 3.5. Very sharp, even considering the fog over here. In the city, at a distance of about 7 to 8 meters from those guys, aperture 2.2, everything is sharp. The red pops out again. Do you see that? Even from the shadow. Anaglyph structures, very nice overall. One additional detail over here, this is very film-like yellow. There is a mild field curvature up to about 2.8, not noticeable in general scenes. Quite common at the time, but quite common in zoom lenses today. We're not noticing it today because of the autofocus. So if you're shooting a portrait wide open, use live view. Otherwise, it is quite possible that you will back focus. But this image helped me also assess the front bokeh, which is lovely. And the back bokeh is generally nice, pleasant, which is kind of rare for a wide-angle lens. ISO 560. Look at the red. And this is from the other side of the porch, behind me. You see the sun is not out yet. So this is reflected light from the sky. This would be a comparative assessment of these five wide-angle lenses according to tests that I did in my old gear days. And some of these tests I have published. The first issue over here, for example, you saw in this video. Some people are going to ask, is this a film-looking lens? Well, each film has its own color palette. My favorite film in Greece was the Agfa Optima 125, which I found on Flickr. And as you can see, it has its own color palette. So I wouldn't really obsess about that. If you visit Flickr, you will see this transparent fullness of colors, especially the red, anywhere it appears. Does this mean that the lens is going to produce miracles? No. It means that when the light is good, you're not going to have to use the vibrance or the saturation slider, which both produce kind of fake digital colors, so your prints are going to look better. And having used this lens, I can tell you that this red is not edited. There is, of course, another trick about this lens that some people have found out. Just like its cousin, the 28F2, this lens also focuses from only 10 inches away, which means it can replace your macro, even more so because it's a little sharper. But are you going to use it? Because it's not smart having many lenses of around the same focal. This is the maximum price that I would pay for this lens. I would not buy it from the Japanese because they overprice it. Well, this is not supposed to be a very normal video.
Sadly, DP Review made a slip-up. I don't know if they're ever going to be invited to New York again. You know, flown in and stayed at the hotel to review like some other reviewers.
A lot of my shots weren't getting the full benefit of those 60 megapixels because of a little bit of motion blur, or, you know, handheld cameras when you're shooting low-light situations.
Excuse me. This is not motion blur. This is what motion blur looks like. If anybody told me, without knowing anything else, that the camera has low noise at 36 megapixels and higher noise at 60 megapixels, which makes no sense because the photo sites don't change size.
Talk about the sensor. If you look at that sensor and compare it to like an M10R sensor, you're going to see it is slightly smaller.
The sensor is smaller, and then they showed me that picture. I would have said, if I didn't know anything else, that the Leica M11 is a 36 megapixel sensor in reality, which upscales the image internally. When the light is good and the ISO is low, then the picture is great. I do not know anything about this camera, but if somebody had given me these symptoms about any camera, I would have told them this is a 36 megapixel camera. Now let's leave the sharp stuff and go to blurry stuff. You remember this image from the video Intuition? It was Michigan 2018. I noticed the form and I pulled over to take a picture. The word for beautiful in Greek is omorpho, which means something that has a fine form.
There's something I find so incredibly modern about this photograph. There's something really timeless about it.
This is the image she is talking about.
The only strong detail in it is this button. It's one of the things that's in sharpest focus.
Today, if you take a picture like this, you will probably throw it away, because it's out of focus.
But this picture's out of focus. Now, if I was to hand that in at the weekend for the Observer magazine, I'd never get it published.
I made a video about this 3 years ago, because our memories contain mostly forms and the impression that these forms have given us. The problem, though, in the sharp portraits is not the sharpness itself. The problem is that the sharpness overwhelms the form.
She said that, you know, when other photographers take photographs, they screw the lens on until the image looks sharp.
Yes, this is what we generally do, because we take pride in our gear and our technical capacity.
And I just focus it until it looks beautiful. That was her goal. She used the word beauty a lot.
We're going to probably forget all these because the form is not there. They're based on gear and technique. But did you ever forget this one? Or the painting I had at the Calenture video? I would like to replay a little bit of it again. Thanks a lot. Bye.
Just.